Hello, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Testing. Alhamdulillah nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu wa nastaghfiruhu wa nu'minu bihi wa natawakkalu alayh. Na'udhu billahi min shururi anfusina wa min sayyiati a'malina. Man yahdihillahu fala mudilla lahu wa man yudlil fala hadiya lahu. Nashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu. Nashhadu anna sayyidina wa maulana Muhammadan 'abduhu wa rasuluhu sallallahu alaihi wasallam. الله أكبر
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا أما بعد يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Him for help and protection and we seek His refuge from the evils of our actions. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of absolute love, that there is no deity worthy of worship except for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone, with no associates in His oneness. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, amma yaquluna uluwan kabira. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His servant and His final messenger. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace and blessings upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his family, upon his companions, and upon everyone who follows their path until the day of judgment. Ameen. Allahumma ameen. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, fear Allah as He should be feared, and die not except in the state of Islam. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us die as Muslims and to resurrect us as Muslims. Ameen. Allahumma ameen. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, last night we talked about Iman, we talked about faith, and we talked about the beautiful hadith in which we find Jibreel coming to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the form of a human. And he came and asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam about Islam, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam defined Islam for us. And we said that this hadith is an authentic hadith. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam defined for us what Islam is. And then he was asked about Iman. And then he defined what Iman is for us. And we got to know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Al-Iman an tu'mina billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rusulihi واليوم الآخر والقدر خيره وشره. That Iman, faith, believing Allah involves what? Believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believing in His angels, believing in His books that He sent to His messengers, believing in the messengers, and believing in the last day. And the sixth article is to believe in fate, in preordainment, and to believe in it, the good or the bad ones. Whatever you like or you dislike, you believe that it is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. And having this kind of acceptance of whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written for you. These six articles of faith, they explain our Iman. And we said that Iman is not seen, while Islam and the rituals that reflect your Islam can be seen by the people around you. Islam, when you perform the pillars of Islam, everyone see you. People can judge your Islam, whether you are Muslim or not, based on the rituals that you do. Saying, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah. You say it loud and you say it clear when the person enters Islam, so people get to know that he is becoming a Muslim. Performing the five prayers also, signs of being a Muslim. So while we can see, while we can tell whether a person is a Muslim or not, we don't have the knowledge or the tools to see whether a person is a mu'min or not. That is up to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's not up to us to judge people and to judge their level of Iman. But as we said, for us, because this is a personal matter, it is up to us to work hard and to do our best to purify our hearts and try to increase the level of Iman that we have in our hearts. So last night we couldn't tap on what tools, what things that can help us to increase our Iman. And that's what we are going to talk about today. What increases our Iman and what decreases our Iman. And as we said, Iman is between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What you have in your heart, no one can see. And that is, subhanAllah, that's the beauty of Iman. Because it's the person who sees how close they are with Allah, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are the ones who guards their own heart. And they can test, and also they can evaluate their relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we said, Al-Iman is not just mere words. Because we talked about the Bedouins who came to the Medina and they converted to Islam, and immediately after they entered Islam, they converted to Islam, they said, Amanna, we have believed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed ayat, correcting their understanding and saying that you haven't believed yet. You can say that you are Muslims. Walakin qulu aslamna. But rather say, we have become Muslims. Because believe, that's a higher degree. Believe, when you transform the words of saying La ilaha illallah into actions, you start seeing the world through La ilaha illallah. That's when you have believe. That's when everything in the world, whatever you do, the way you treat yourself, the way you treat your family, the way you treat the world, is based on La ilaha illallah. Muhammadun Rasulullah, that is when you achieve the level of Iman. Al-Iman laysa bit-tahalli wala bit-tamanni. Iman is not mere wishes. It's not, subhanAllah, you know, decorating your external look with the looks of Iman. It's not that. It's not adornment. It's not wishes. It's not mere words. What it is that ما وقر في القلب وصدقه العمل. Al-Iman is what resides in your heart and it is confirmed by actions. That is what Iman is. You believe, you say that you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will be shown in whatever you do. That will be a reflection of your love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will immediately follow His messenger. قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. Say, Ya Muhammad, to them, if you say that you love Allah, you have love in your heart for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then follow me. Subhanallah. And as we said, ما وقر في القلب وصدقه العمل. It's what resides in the heart and it is confirmed by actions. Now, it is in our belief, in our faith, is that Iman increases by doing good deeds, by trying to be closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by forcing yourself, your nafs, to stop, to refrain from doing sins, and by forcing your nafs also to do the acts of worship. To start with fara'id, for example, you want to sleep, or you want to go to play, or you want to do whatever you need to do, but it is the time for asr, it is time for maghrib. That is when you stop yourself from being too involved in this world, and by stopping whatever you do and moving towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and doing the acts of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you to do, that's the first step that will help you to increase your Iman. And as we said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in many ayat in Quran what tells us that Iman increases and decreases. One of these ayat is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا تُلْيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَأْدَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. When the ayat of Quran are recited to them, when they hear the words of Allah, their Iman increases. Allahu Akbar. And this tells us that the best tool, the best thing that can boost your Iman is Quran. Either reading Quran or listening to Quran. Because this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. And He said it also in another surah, in Surah Az-Zumar, the same meaning. That the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fills the hearts with peace. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. Subhanallah. Remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Listening to the ayat of Quran. وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلَيْهِمْ آيَاتُهُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. When the ayat of Quran are recited to them, they listen to Quran, what happens to them? زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا. Allahu Akbar. Their Iman increases. They feel that their Iman is boosted, is strengthened. Subhanallah. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created things and created causes for these things to increase or decrease. And as we said, Iman is the best thing that we can, subhanallah, seek. The best thing that we need to strive to get, subhanallah. Because it is the thing that will lead you to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us about Iman, and He told us about the things that can help us to increase Iman. And the best of them all is to have the beneficial knowledge, the real and true knowledge, the knowledge that we can acquire from Quran and from Sunnah. And it involves that we exert the efforts to know what is true, what is wrong, what is added, what is fake, what is authentic, and what is not authentic. That is also upon us. Getting the beneficial knowledge, learning Quran, listening to the ayat of Quran, and you will not be able to get into the degree of contemplating on the meanings of Quran unless you have spent hours days of your time to learn even a few surahs. Give it some time. Learn the meanings of these surahs. Listen to them again and again, because after you get the knowledge, after you understand the meanings of this ayat, it starts to touch your heart. So as we said, the true beneficial knowledge is the knowledge that comes from Quran and from the ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it is upon us to know which ahadith are authentic and which ahadith are fake. And subhanallah, you know, that's very important, because much of the trouble that is added to our religion is because of the fake ahadith that were attributed to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, while the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not say those ahadith. And Allah knows best. Now, what happens when you get the beneficial knowledge? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions this in Quran, and he said, شَهِدَ اللَّهُ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَٰهَ إِلَّا هُوَ وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ وَأُولُو الْعِلْمِ قَائِمًا بِالْقِسْطِ. Allahu Akbar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that Allah bears the testimony that there is no God but Him, and also the angels bear the same testimony that no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the third entity that bears the testimony that there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those who have knowledge. You get to that level in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned His name first, and then He added the angels testifying that there is no God but Him, and then He mentioned those who have knowledge. Allahu Akbar. That is subhanAllah. In another beautiful ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. It is only those who have knowledge among you who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. What could be better than this? Having the true faith, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, having taqwa in the heart of in your heart, taqwa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here is testifying in this beautiful ayah, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَ اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاء. It is only those among you, those who have knowledge, who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the level you get when you strive to get the beneficial knowledge. When you seek knowledge, when you start giving time to know more about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to know more ahadith, to know your religion. And knowledge, subhanallah, will grant you the ability to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala out of love, because you know him, you love him, you do the acts of worship because you know the one that you are worshiping. Allahu Akbar. An Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan, Amir al-Mu'mineen. Muawiyah ibn Abi Sufyan narrated that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qal, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. Allahu Akbar. If Allah intends well to happen to any of His servants, what will happen to them? He will lead them to get more knowledge. They will have more understanding of deen. He will lead them to fiqh. And fiqh is not restricted to the science fiqh that we know now. It encompasses all religious knowledge. Knowing about the life of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, knowing about tawheed, knowing more about Quran, ahadith, etc. يُفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. Allahu Akbar. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala intends good, intends well for one of His servants, He subhanahu wa ta'ala directs them to acquire more knowledge, to become fuqaha fi deen. And it doesn't necessarily mean that you leave everything behind you and you just go and sit in the masjid or sit like with a shaykh and study day and night. It means that you do your best to know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the best knowledge. To know when you say La ilaha illallah, to know the meaning of La ilaha illallah, to know what it involves, the meanings behind it. And you say Muhammadun Rasulullah. You know the meaning behind Muhammad Rasulullah and what it involves. And that when you have that belief that resides in your heart, when you feel it in your heart, and when you see the world through La ilaha illallah, Muhammadun Rasulullah, that is when you know that you have achieved the level of Iman. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم استغفر الله. الحمد لله وكفى وصلاة وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى. الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, another thing that can help us to increase our iman is to look at the ayat kawniya around us, to look at the universal signs, to look at what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created, and to look at the beauty, to contemplate on the beauty that resides in every single thing that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created. And throughout Quran, there are many ayat in which the beginning of the ayah starts by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us to look at the world, to look at His creation, what He's created, and then that ayah ends by asking this question, أَفَلَا يَتَذَكَّرُونَ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ, telling us that there are ayat for those who understand, for those who contemplate, for those who have minds. And then, you know, there are two ayat, subhanAllah, of similar meaning. One of them in Surah Al-Baqarah and the other one in Surah Ali Imran. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ. Indeed, in the creation of the heavens and the earth, and in the succession of day and night, there are ayat for those who ponder over the meanings, those who reflect on the meanings of these ayat, for those who understand, for those who have minds. And similar meaning also in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allahu Akbar. And then there is the beautiful surah that we always read on Surah Al-Jumu'ah, the ending of Surah Al-Ghashiyah, أَفَلَا يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبْلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت. الله أكبر. أفلا ينظرون, don't they see at the camels, look at the camels and how beautiful they are, and don't they ask themselves how these camels were created. There are signs, and in the modern kind of science, if you read more about the camels, you'll see how beautiful and how, subhanAllah, ayat were put in the creation of camels. أَفَلَا يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبْلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ كَيْفَ رُفِعَتْ. Allahu Akbar. إِلَى السَّمَاءِ. Look at the skies. Look at the skies, subhanAllah. Look at the beauty, and there are many ayat in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us to look around us, to the stars, to the sun, to the moon. Look at this beautiful, amazing universe. Allahu Akbar. وَإِلَى الْجِبَالِ كَيْفَ نُصِبَتْ. Look at these beautiful mountains. And subhanAllah, many ayat also talked about these beautiful mountains. وَتَرَى الْجِبَالَ تَحْسَبُهَا جَامِدًا وَهِيَ تَمُرُّ مَرَّ السَّحَابِ. You look at these mountains, subhanAllah, how strong, who built them? And you look at them, subhanAllah, and you see that they are, you know, stable while they are moving in a most beautiful and amazing, miraculously, subhanAllah. أَفَلَا يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَى الْإِبْلِ كَيْفَ خُلِقَتْ وَإِلَى السَّمَاءِ كَيْفَ رُفِعَتْ وَإِلَى الْجِبَالِ كَيْفَ نُصِبَتْ وَإِلَى الْأَرْضِ كَيْفَ سُطِحَتْ. Look at this beautiful land that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made humble, ready for us to be cultivated. Ready for us, subhanAllah, while this earth is moving day and night. But for us, subhanAllah, it is stable. And we get our houses, and we get to enjoy, and we get to drive our cars. Allahu Akbar, subhanAllah al-Azim. Inna fi dhalika la-ayat. Truly there are signs in whatever you see. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us the ability to see the beauty of everything that He has created. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. One more thing that can help us to increase our iman is to exert the efforts to do more righteous deeds. Because as we said, it starts with belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You get the belief by the beneficial knowledge, by knowing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's how you have the true belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know about Him, you learn, you study, you do your homework. You know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's the belief. You help yourself to boost your iman by looking at the signs. Look at the sky. Spend some time, subhanAllah. Go outside. Look at the beautiful, subhanAllah, you know, everything, subhanAllah, when you give it some time, you get to realize that it is created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And again, you need to find the thing that strengthens your iman. You are the one who knows yourself the best. And there are things that, subhanAllah, when you contemplate on them, when you give them some time, you start by, yeah, subhanAllah, you end up saying, Allah, this is amazing. This is created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you are the expert in terms of what strengthens your iman, what ayah, what signs is, subhanAllah, you know, drives your iman to become bigger and bigger. You are the one who knows the best, subhanAllah. And then, as we said, it must be reflected by your actions. It's not just enough to say that I believe, I know that Allah is there. And then when you are asked to share what you have, give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, charity, do the fasting, perform the five prayers, they say, no, I just, you know, I have faith, my heart is full with iman, and that's it. That this contradicts the idea of iman. Because if you say, as we said in the ayah, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهِ. If you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that means you will follow His messenger and you will start doing the acts of worship that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded you to do. And when you talk about the acts of worship, there are many levels and many ways to categorize these good deeds. But we can say that there are good deeds that involve the hearts, and there are good deeds that involve the tongue, and there are deeds that involve your limbs. When we start with the heart, we said having sincere intention that you do whatever you do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. You try to purify your heart from any kind of hatred, from any kind of hypocrisy, from any kind of pretension. You do what you do for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. And also one of the ibadat that relates to the heart is having sincere tawakkul on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Complete and conditional reliance on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. You do what you do, you seek whatever you seek, but you know that it is Allah who's gonna give it to you, or it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who's gonna drive that thing that you seek, drive it away from you. So, at-tawakkul ala Allah, al-iman billah, all of these ibadat that involves being honest, for example, no one knows when you say what you say, no one knows that whether that is true or false, but it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who knows. And that is, again, being honest, that is also one of the ibadat that relates to the heart. And we talk about patience, we talk about, you know, contentment, we talk about many ibadah, and the whole idea behind it is that you do whatever you do sincerely for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant you pure heart, because it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahu Akbar, it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who controls the heart. We ask, this is why we make the dua, ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala ta'atik, ameen. Allahumma ameen. And also of the acts of worship that involve the tongue, qira'atul Qur'an, reading the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, understanding the meaning of Qur'an, reading more of the ayat, and wallahi subhanallah, as we said in the ayah, the best way and the easiest way and the most amazing way to increase your iman is reading Qur'an or listening to Qur'an. Understanding the meaning of Qur'an will definitely increase your iman, because this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Inshallah, we'll cover this topic in another khutbah, إِذَا أَحْيَانَ اللَّهِ. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to fill our hearts with iman. We ask Him subhanahu wa ta'ala to instill the love for him in our hearts and to bring us closer to him. And we ask him subhanahu wa ta'ala to show us the right way to win his pleasure. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. Rabbana alayka tawakkalna wa ilayka anabna wa ilayka al-masir. Rabbana aghfir lana wa li-ikhwanina alladhina sabaquna bil-iman. ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم لا تدع لنا في مقامنا هذا ذنبا إلا غفرته ولا همّا إلا فرجته ولا دينا إلا قضيته ولا ولدا إلا أصلحته ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا هي لك رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا يسرتها لنا وأعنتنا على قضائها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا وقرة عيوننا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولا تنسوه يخذلكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وجزاكم الله خيرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وأقم الصلاة.